wonder if the Northern Irish team get an England dodgeball, or whether they see them enough. Over on our other court, court two, the Egyptian women are taken to the court and they're going to face up against Austria.
I'm back, Jake.
He's back. It's all good. They're the Austrian girls.
Here they are.
The strong favourites in this tournament.
I've just heard from some of the guys watching the Malaysian team, they're saying England's biggest competition, looking absolute deadly. Here they are,
being made for all the teams.
Northern Ireland women against England women on court one, with yet another ball to give the English women. They've got another ball to hand over.
I was just saying before, do you reckon the Northern Irish get a dodgeball? Because we see them all the time.
Yeah. And on court two, we've got Austria women.
Yep.
The Egypt women.
But no one cares because the Austrians are dancing.
There we go. Austrians are getting the thing. There we go. The Northern Irish girls are so happy.
They got themselves a little Sporticus dodgeball.
Apparently they're selling for now £15. So that's it.
Excellent. The value will only decrease as they give more away.
Exactly. Yeah.
Bit of a change to the English starting six. We've now got Jonah and Liv Morris is already on court starting out there. That seems to be, I think they seem to have two or three rotations. This looks like the second. Northern Ireland, pretty much unchanged in first time, but the positions seem to have moved around. You've taken the winger Kat and so put her in the middle. Although this could just be for the initial rush trying to get that central ball. Oh, a sock. We get a sock.
Here we go, we're off to a good start now. Who gets the centre? The English girls get the centre ball.
Three ball volley. Oh, it's two hits.
No, you're out first.
The catch doesn't count. That's decimated the Northern Irish team already.
There we go.
Half of them in one volley.
Number four, Holly Edmonds goes out. Beth Dix gets the ball. She's deadly on that counter. Are we going to see it now?
Three from Northern Ireland. Trying to shut down Charlotte. Charlotte sends it high.
But Beth goes out on the dodge. She's hit on her leg. Block there made by the Northern Irish women. They've got to throw. Majority of balls in their side.
First, the key on the right hand side there, suppressed by Jim and I from England.
The timing of English balls coming forward.
The English have the majority. It's not really in their half, but.
There we go.
No one's half.
Oh, hitting her hand as she comes down.
Yep, she knows that. She's gone. England to play.
Oh, Kat drops there and the hit there. England take the first set against the Northern Irish women. I've heard news also, Jake, that the England's men are decimating. The England's mixed are decimating the Invitational.
Okay.
In the other hall. I'm not sure if that is being live streamed. I'm not too sure. I heard it was, then I heard it wasn't. It's definitely not being live streamed from us, but...
No, I'd love to bring you updates. We'll pass on any info we do here.
Cats forcing that pressure. Gemini gets the ball on the right. Oh, hit there on Holly. Liv comes back. Yeah, Beth has that ball on the left. Here we go. This is the deadly counter we've been seeing. Can she do anything? There we go. Comes forward. There we go.
It's one hit from the counter. Gemini goes wide.
And four balls.
Kira gets out of the way.
Oh, all three going to the right of player.
Yep, no, she's got that. Just enough of a dodge. Efficient.
Hit there. Gemini goes for something she shouldn't have. All English girls have a ball on court. Oh, takes it
straight down the line.
Liv gets hit also, and number seven, I think.
Nothing on number seven.
Nothing
in the minute,
on seven.
Two.
Oh, she drops it. Missed control of ball there. England 2-on-1. Can they do anything? No.
She's not looking for the counter. She wants that catch.
She does want that catch. That catch is so crucial. As everyone says, catches win matches. Catches win sets now, actually.
Yeah, it just doesn't work.
Yeah, it doesn't. It doesn't. She's hit there. Charlotte, the captain. Oh!
I really thought she had that.
So did I. Charlotte, the captain, takes the second set.
In England's favour.
Both teams line up. Cat looking for that centre ball. And Holly looking for that centre ball. Who's getting it? Cat swipes it back. They take the three. They take the four.
They don't have a lot of time to react. Are they going to be able to use all four? Looks like they will.
One hit, Holly in the
just
middle.
Just one hit. Egypt-Austria score. It's 2-0 to Austria over on court two at the moment.
Cat takes the catch there from Liv. Disappointed with her throw.
Stronger showing this time from Northern Ireland. A little bit tighter.
Putting a lot.
A little more comfortable.
Yeah, putting a lot more pressure on the girls, which is what we like to see. If they're going to win it, they don't want England to win it easy. Oh. Beth, Charlotte and Gemini come forward with a three. A hit there.
No hit on the other side. Allowing Q to get that counter away.
We've got six balls.
That is one too many.
One too many indeed. There we go. Ah, she's dropped and missed control there. Gemini dodges out the way.
Looks like she thought about that catch.
Yeah, I know. She wanted that there. Sarah and Charlotte and Beth all come forward. Hit there and a hit there. Balls collided, apparently. Charlotte doesn't look happy with that decision, Jake.
Certainly doesn't, but no harm done.
Exactly. Oh,
it looks like. What's the ref saying?
It's hit touched first. The floor.
Yeah. Oh, to the floor.
To the floor, no catch.
No catch.
Three sets to nothing here. On court two, the scores are.
3 to Austria.
And 0 to Egypt.
That's a strong side, the Austrians. I reckon we're definitely fancying them going through in a very, very strong position.
Yeah.
So it's not too surprising that scoreline is as it is at this stage. Back here on court one. Looks like we've lost a Northern Irish player. Full complement of English girls on the other side. Liv Morris in the middle taking what looks like an easy catch, but I'm pretty sure it wouldn't be if you were there on the court yourself. Referee's doing an awful lot of talking. He's having to manage to
get a lot more. Holly hit there while she's in the air. Beth misses the counter, tracking back.
Four players against three players.
Oh, hit there. And a hit there.
Oh, that's a block. One second. We're all good.
Play ball on the Northern Ireland girls.
Doesn't get out of the way of the counter, just tracks back in a straight line.
I'd like to see some stats on this, Jake. Unfortunately, we don't have stats monitors, but out of how many counters has Beth probably hit now?
Oh, I don't know. I would hazard a guess at 75, 80%.
Yeah. Good guess on stats there. Good guess. She'll probably be unhappy. She'll probably say something like 95. Percent.
She'll say what she wants.
You're the commentator.
I don't know what the
here,
stats
Jake.
Are.
Yeah, that's it.
Hoping for a quick restart. It doesn't seem to be coming. Still missing a dodgeball. Just bouncing its way back onto court. But England lead Northern Ireland 4-0. To the 289 of you watching now. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, or good morning, or good night. Depends where
just
you're watching
good,
from.
Good day, good time.
Exactly. Charlotte takes that catch there. Hits.
Block from Beth Redmond.
Ah, oh, Liv. One ball off here.
We'll have three balls. 5 seconds isn't yet in play.
There we go. Northern Ireland girls with a three. They've got a throw. Play ball's been called. Oh, hit there. Unbelievable.
I'm surprised she went for that in that manner. She's gone down, she set herself, and then gone reaching. Efficient. Oh, she thought she was safe.
I think she's been hit.
There's a fourth ball.
Moya Lee, last Northern Irish girl remaining.
Oh. No catch.
Hit by two.
Not a catch. Starting to come towards the end of the first half. At least one set to play. And at least a second. But whether that will finish after the full duration or not remains to be seen.
Oh,
yeah, she got caught.
There we go again. The Northern Irish 5 against the English 6.
Someone's knee pads falling off.
Hit there on Moya.
Liv keeps out the way of all three of those at her. Equally, Northern Irish 11, Smith. Avoids the counter on return.
Emily taking that block there.
Ball.
Play ball being scored.
Like. 3 seconds. Two. Plenty of time.
Oh, Gemini's hit there.
One,
hit there on
that.
The arm. Oh.
That is a good hit. And she's gone down heavy. She's gone down hard.
She went very heavy on that knee.
And a jaw, by the looks of it. She really knocked herself going there. 4 players apiece.
Here we go, Northern Ireland coming forward. Oh, that.
Just put them all around, Liv, there, as she manages to get herself through that volley.
Here we go. Catch there.
Catch in the
hit
middle,
there as well.
Right.
Goes down Northern Irish 3. Northern Irish 4,
Northern
actually.
Irish 4 from the catch, 3 English.
You can't see Beth Dix here. There, she's coming forward.
Oh,
deflected
73%.
Down. 73%. There we go. That's it. Charlotte coming forward. Hit on the deflection there. 3 apiece.
Some nice efficient dodging on this. Moving just as much as they need to. Cat takes them to the face from the looks of that.
Two Northern Irish girls left here. Nope. 2-1. Just the one.
Just the one. Locked all three. Get on.
Oh, Beth!
Beth has fluffed the catch on the return.
She wanted that.
Ah, she knows she's got away with that.
She's annoyed with herself there.
Susie Vickers, she knows she's just been given a gift there.
Can she do anything else? Oh, it's coming.
She can't catch two.
I think she's hit there.
She is, just off that glancing left shoulder.
Six sets for England. Northern Irish team, 0. Over on court 2, Austria 7, Egypt with 0.
Big scores both sides, and still got clean sheets for what arguably be the two favourite teams in their respective matches. The ones you'd expect to be dominating really are. Although, surprised that the Northern Irish haven't managed to clinch any of these points. It just looks like England were able to just close them out. It's
one of those games that is just not...
It's not going for them.
Oh,
blocked
that there.
Wendy Lee caught right in the middle of the court.
Block there. Oh.
But that block put her off a throwing stride there. She's lucky to get away without that being called invalid.
Very close to the invalid call there.
5 balls from England.
Oh, all 4 being fired. Only one goes out. You should be looking at more hits than that with a 4-ball push.
You'd think.
There we go. 7-0 at the end of the first half.
So just getting that one hit was all they really needed, it seems.
Exactly that. 5 minutes. Break.
Egypt seem to have pulled one back on court 2. It's Egypt 1, Austria 8. So Austria is still with a convincing lead at the halfway stage.
Yeah. It's one of those points, I think, that is given, you know,
from a draw,
at the end, yeah.
Still, it's a point they may come to rely on later on.
Exactly that.
Compares asking everyone to make the respective noises for their respective teams. It looks like they're all lining up for the second half. That is a really quick 5-minute break.
It was. It gets quicker and quicker. I think they're trying to cut down on the time. We are running so far behind.
Yep, as I'm sure you'd expect.
Oh, of course. Yeah.
Behind time on a dodgeball event.
Everyone that comes to a UKDB event will know exactly what we mean.
Hear that? That's head ref Andy Carson asking for a ball retriever.
And the coach, she looks so annoyed because she wants to take it, but they can't. They can't grab it.
They can't.
Oh, Joe's disappointed there. Yeah. I spoke to Joe earlier. I had a quick word with her. She's playing well. We said good things about her. She was a bit disappointed with her performance. I mean, you can't be. You can't be at this standard.
Probably not, but she's probably one of those players that thinks if she can improve, she'll want to improve.
Yeah.
So anything that she's identified in her own personal game is something that she's going to want to address.
Marking him down, but the score's not really like who's at where. Don't worry about it. Obviously, when...
Waiting for another dodgeball. It's on Northern Ireland side. So they'll be bringing the next attack. Yeah, it just sort of goes away. Doesn't really do anything. England's reply is a hit on Moya Lee.
Northern Ireland ball retriever being called forward yet again. They've got to be sharper than this because the girls just need the balls as quick as they can.
Yeah, it's slowing the pace of the game right down. That's not going to do either team any favours.
Over in England, I think everyone just... We have a rule that you can run off, but it has to be a past the return line.
That's correct, yeah. A player from the game can run off the court and collect their own balls, provided it's on their half of the court.
Of course.
In UK dodgeball, and I believe in European dodgeball, it's a similar idea, but... This ball retriever is a new addition to make sure that the players active are staying on the court.
That's nice. There's a lot more focus on the playing rather than running
like
off
the,
court.
The admin of collecting your own balls.
We do see that in some non-European countries. I've seen that over in the Asian Championships. They have that over there. They have ball boys and ball girls over there.
Ball folks. Is that yet? The pre-throw finds its mark on Northern Irish number 11.
Catch it! Oh!
Cat didn't even look up. She assumed that was gone.
Now, we saw that earlier with the Clutch Scott catch.
Yep. That's the right thing to do. As soon as you palmed it up, go looking, go searching.
Your eyes have to be looking everywhere. Hit there on her knee. She's out. She's gone. Another set to England. Looking remarkably strong.
On the other side, in court two, which we're not yet got an updated score on.
I can see it from here, Jake.
Still 8-1.
Still 8-1 indeed.
The Austrians just seeing a lot more active. The Egyptians a bit more static at the back of court, sort of defending themselves, but... The Austrians are certainly on the offensive. Game back on court one started up. Three balls on the Northern Ireland side. They haven't been told to play yet. They're being forced. Four balls coming. You've got to be getting hits with those, and they do. They find Emily Nichols. Yep. Fairly sure they found Emily Nichols. England's reply finds Kat Hurren. And the ref's calling hit first, so there's some other thing that doesn't count. Lovely pre-throw hit on the Northern Ireland number 8. She catches the back of her foot as she's running forward. Play ball.
England's on the return. Gemini plucks that catch.
She's been looking for one for a
she
while.
She has, she has
left
indeed.
That long,
yeah.
But she's out as well.
What's happened? She's no catch made.
Interesting. She must have been glanced by the ball that came at her.
I think
beforehand.
So, yeah.
From our angle, I couldn't quite tell. So the Northern Irish player, I believe it's Moya, has been brought back in. Moya Lee.
Yeah.
The target of yet another England attack. Now Andy Carson's called her out. I'm not entirely sure if that was the right call, but
I'm
he's
not
done
sure
what he's
either.
Done.
Ref's discretion. Ref's call. Ref's call is final. England girls go forward. Hit there on her foot.
That is.
Beth pressuring. She's pressuring the front of the court.
She's got one remaining Northern Irish girl, number 11.
Now, if this ball collector was...
Oh, she's gone!
sliding
catch.
Of Emily Nichols.
That's what we like to see. Acrobatic catches like that. Girls come forward. Cat.
Brings Cat in. Can they capitalise? Can Beth, energy in it now?
Beth hit.
No.
Beth hitting yet another counter. Cat, what can she do?
She's on her own. She's got the majority of the balls. Here comes the counter.
Oh, Beth hits again.
I thought she had that.
I thought she had that also.
Looks like a bit of a team change around. Northern Irish coach Egg White rearranging things for the girls going on.
Yeah, yes indeed.
England, we're seeing a couple of changes as well. Emily Walker's walking on, I guess, as is her wont. With another new arrival on the England side there, number 8, Lauren Hems. I don't think we've seen her yet.
I don't think we've seen her. Nice to see a new face. 9. Oh. Nice. I think she was hit there as well, number 8. A bit of team fitness.
The refs missed it.
Team fitness for these ball collectors here.
A block and Gemini gets a cheeky catch. That was brilliant.
Once you start taking one catch, Jake, it becomes a lot easier. Your confidence builds. We used to have a tactic, a man called Alex Shorty. I don't know if you ever played with him. Alex
Not
Short?
By that name.
No.
Or maybe.
Shorty. Small, stumpy guy. Anyway.
No way.
Yeah. Before we, a tournament, we used to just give him some free catches. Look like you're throwing hard. Make him. Because you have to be mentally prepared to take that catch.
Oh, yeah, you got to get in. It's about setting the position.
Yeah.
3 from Northern Ireland.
Oh, Gemini takes another catch. Oh!
Beautiful catch.
I think she was caught first, Joe. Joe's not off.
We need to know whose ball is whose.
Pause the time here. Decision has to get made. I think Gemini took that catch there. But what a good catch.
Yes. I just had to temper my language. Yes, it was a very good catch. Short range.
We've seen a lot of attempts at those today already.
Yeah, several. I think, we saw loads and loads in the
USA
game.
Yeah.
That we had on court one just before. So many one-on-ones there.
Oh, I know.
Andy Carson's brought the players in. We have paused time once again.
Apparently a catch is made.
So what has won?
Both catches are secure.
Well, that there's no doubt, but it's the real question is, was it the Northern Irish catcher's ball that was caught before?
I think.
By Gemini. The England
so
number 6.
So Joe comes back on due to the catch. Anyway.
Yes, I suppose she does.
I'm not too sure on that one. No, she's off yet. 1 foot wasn't in the box. I think she knows that herself.
It's an annoying rule, but...
It is an annoying rule. You've got to sprint to the outbox if you want to get back in quick.
The situation's being explained to Northern Ireland. We're losing ever more time.
No, time has been paused, apparently. Okie dokie, the 1:30 has gone off the set clock, but 7 minutes 29 is right for the overall second half of this game.
England get ready for another set piece. Can they be disturbed by Cat? No, her
she comes forward. Gemini takes yet another catch.
It's on fire now, that's 3. Northern Ireland have to play with their 2 players. They're not together.
Gemini, another one.
She doesn't get the hits. She wants everything in this game, that girl.
She's found her form.
Yeah.
I do believe, I reckon she could be starting next game.
I think it's time to stop putting those balls so close to her.
Exactly. Oh, catch then hit made. Moya
great
comes
composure.
On. What can she do?
Everything.
Bounce there.
First. She's still good. She's still alive. She has three balls, so she's going to
she's
have to
got
do
a
some
throw.
Work. She's taking one up. She's going to get counted.
Oh, there we go. So she's taking a tactical throw there. She's throwing from further back.
Yep.
Give not to be counted.
To
yeah.
Back,
she's doing it again.
Throw. I'm surprised Emily didn't drop and catch that one.
So though. Am I. I think she knew it was coming in slow. No,
nothing
no
there,
hit
there.
She's got possession of balls again. She's got a throw.
But only 20 seconds or so in this set.
I think it could be less than that. We're not too sure. We're waiting on Carson's whistle. Joe comes forward. And that's time.
That's time. Yep, they've seen that one out. A safe play from England, but
exactly. Smile from number 10 there, Emily Walker. I think they're all happy with their performance. Keeping a clean sheet.
Yeah, it's so far so good for them. It's off with the majority going to Northern Ireland. Can they make something of this three? Oh, Emily Walker's dropped a sitter. She seems like she's been brought back in from that. Sorry, we had a moment.
Oh, it hit there.
We dodgeball ourselves.
Liv looking for to put the ball on the court. Great dodge. Oh, she's hurt her knee there.
That's the second time, I think.
Oh, yeah, it was her other knee last time.
Yeah.
Oh, hit there. She hasn't even realised until it's come and hit her soul.
That's just a hard
here we go. First yellow card.
Stunning.
You listen to the ref. You don't make your own decisions. First yellow card here.
I'm not sure she knows what it's for.
There we go.
Ooh, he's a harsh taskmaster, Mr. Carson.
And I do believe that yellow card will play over to the next sets.
I suspect it will. Yeah, we're running out of time. We've only got just under 4 minutes left in this half.
So it'll play on to the next set after this. And a bit onto the next game as well, but I don't think it'll matter because they can make a substitution there.
Absolutely.
Oh, Gemini wanted one too many.
She looks like she's winding up for a counter. Northern Irish, number 11, Smith. Free throw instead.
Oh, catch there.
And it was caught.
She was caught aback.
It's a common one.
It's a common
one. That free throw, you're not really too bothered where it goes.
Yeah.
Someone at the back. Just
you try and pressure that thrower in the middle. The ball comes out slow. Someone plucks it out from out of nowhere.
So not an awful lot of time left. Probably just enough time for one more game unless these girls really, really rush through. Side.
And a score update on court two. 12, I nearly got hit in the face. 12 points to Austria and 3 to Egypt over on court two.
Good work on Egypt, pulling a couple of points back. Yeah.
Oh, Carson's just offered a red card out. He's told the lady that is simbined, if she goes for another ball, she'll be red carded.
That's it. She cannot leave that box under any circumstances, even in an attempt to retrieve a ball for the rest of her team. She is out of the game.
Is that out of the whole tournament?
Well, I mean, at the moment, she's currently
she cannot leave the game.
I'm not sure what the red card would mean at this stage. We're going to have to find out. I hope we don't have
Oh, one. Yeah. Part of me says I don't want to see one. Part of me does.
Hit there on the Northern Irish girl. She's running back.
Not long left of the second half of this game. We're currently at 11-0 to England against Northern Ireland.
Yet another scoreline that doesn't quite seem to reflect the standard of play.
We're getting them all day. I think they'll be a lot closer, like we've said. She could have caught
good
that.
Good counter. She could have had it. She didn't quite have the composure.
I know we're going to keep on relating back to that Scott catch, but it was such a good catch earlier as he jumps off court and plucks it.
Yeah, no, it's good composure.
Yeah.
Did the right thing.
Cat's got to do a lot of throwing to change over possession.
Just thought about that, but Emily Walker put it just wide, just
Cat,
out of the
Cat
way.
Cat comes forward with two. Oh, Cat wants that catch.
She does, but she's also able to get some of these balls back on the England side by dropping them while walking forwards, letting them carry that momentum without it technically being a roll. So that's clever.
Unlucky Cat. Unlucky indeed. She's played well today so far. I mean, I think she wanted a lot more catches than she...
She'll be surprised with how it's going for her in terms of her catching game. That's normally one of her stronger suits.
Time is up there. 1 minute and 4 seconds remaining of that yellow card there when it stopped.
The hands are being shaken, the lion has been let out. Fortunately, Kimber seems relatively tame. And the Austria-Egypt score, that's just reset itself, but it looked like it was 13 to Austria and 3 to Egypt. Big win for England and a big win for Austria.
Exactly. Next game on court one, Jake, we've got the USA women against the Italian women. On court two, we have the Welsh women against the Australian Dodgeroo women team.
Cool beans. Let's see if the American women have learned the lessons of last time. We'll see if their more aggressive playstyle will work in their favour against the Italians. They actually have quite a similar playstyle. Though the Italian catching before, that was absolutely insane.
I'd like to see that more today, but we saw earlier on court one, the USA women being very, very productive in the centre of that court there.
Yeah. We'll see if they are able to shut down the catching of the Italians, or if the rather heated playstyle of both teams leads to something a bit more fun to watch.
Exactly that.